Africa is the only region that registered positive growth, a solid positive growth of plus 4%. However, seen from the modest volume that we're starting from, all support is still needed for Africa, and the emerging destinations in Africa are consolidating those gains. Destinations such as Kenya, South Africa, and Swaziland did particularly well. For the future, we're forecasting that economic situation, if under control as it seems to be, then some slight improvement might be seen, and that would even multiply when affecting the tourism industry. The factor of the AH1N1 is also being managed in the best possible way. However, we are still concerned about the autumn in the northern part of the hemisphere, where the flu seasons is normally more active, and we need to monitor and be vigilant about its effect on our industry. It is still our belief that we can close the year of 2009 at an average, and I underscore average, of minus 5%. In regards to our response, you will be considering and you will be deliberating on a very important document that we have produced to you, the Roadmap for Recovery. I should have it with me. It's the blue book that is being distributed outside, and I sincerely urge all of you to acquaint yourself very well with it. It is a result of very serious meetings, deliberations, discussions, surveys, and feedback from over 100 member states in producing this very practical, very pragmatic document on how we see ourselves moving forward. It is also important that this document leads the way not just on the economic situation, but rather also on how we see ourselves as a very important sector in facilitating and moving towards the transformation to the green economy. Mr. Chairman, dear friends, this is in general how we see the situation moving forward. The document is self-explanatory, and we are moving forward in responding to the double issue, the double challenge of economy and environment, while at the same time dealing with issues that come and present themselves on the scene, like the man-made or the natural crisis that we have been dealing with. There will be a detailed discussion on our efforts in that regard in discussing the roadmap for recovery. And Mr. Chairman, I would spare much of the discussion on this and the explanation to that point in time. The second part pertaining to the main activities undertaken is not an issue that I would like to consume much of your time in trying to restate as it is clearly in the document. But I would, however, highlight a few major issues here that we have been dealing with. Because while it's not business as usual, life must go on and services must continue to be provided to all our members. We have been extremely active in the issue of statistics and lending support to the tourism satellite accounts. We've held the 5th International Conference in Bali on tourism statistics for the first time in conjunction and in coordination with the International Labour Organization, and I'm extremely happy to see the representative of the International Labour Organization with us. We're moving this tool into a tool that will become more capable of measuring the very important employment components into the measurements, which are now still limited to the economic impact of tourism on the national economies. We are also establishing regional hubs. South Africa, Saudi Arabia, Austria, and in the process of establishing another regional hub in America and one in Asia to lend services and support for countries to be able to improve their performance and application of the tourism satellite account. On climate change, there is extensive and detailed explanation in your document on how we are placing ourselves so so firmly within the core group that has been dealing with this and leading up to the Copenhagen conference in December 2009. I can assure you that the travel and tourism industry is very well placed to voice its concerns within the international and global forums, and particularly within the UN circles. We are articulating our position, as has been initiated by the Davos Conference 3 years ago. We are also presenting you with a very important document on travel facilitation that will be an item of discussion in this General Assembly. This is a very important issue that is affecting the flow of people and travel between one destination and another. Many activities are centered around this effort, and still much more will be needed. We are also continuing our work on poverty alleviation through tourism, through the good work of the STEP Foundation and the STEP initiatives. Tens of projects are being conducted. We are benefiting from the donors' assistance of many countries, and may I also, Madam Vice Chair, salute the efforts of the government of Spain, in particular in the MDG Achievement Fund that have been granted to the United Nations to the amount of 500 and above million euros, out of which we were able to execute, we are already executing, 9 projects in different parts of the world on poverty alleviation and the impact of tourism in this endeavor. Many other projects and contributions based on voluntary contributions are on their way, and much more is needed in that regard. The third part, Mr. Chairman, of the report that's in front of you has to do with the administration, financial, and overall health of our organization. I must say, as we are embarking on a new era in management of this organization, and with the president of a very, very distinguished and good person that is with us here this morning, Mr. Francesco Fagiani, a previous former Secretary General, I can assure you that this organization was delivered in the best possible health with regard to its assets and with regard to its prospects to the future. There will be a special tribute to Mr. Fagiani, but it is very important for me to state on record that there is no excuse for any future administration not to move forward into achieving its goals and into moving into even higher plateaus. The financial situation of UNWTO is sound. We have 154 full members, 7 associate members, the accession of the countries that have been stated, and the plans to include much more are part of the administration's plans within the coming 4 years, and they are commitments that must be fulfilled. Income for 2008 and 2009 period, well, as anticipated, reached about 24 million euros. The ability to solicit contributions and the rate of contributions deliverance was over 85%.